We start with a puzzle. Can an object move in one direction and accelerate in another direction? The solution will be given near the end of the video. Welcome to this Nothing Nerdy video on acceleration. Here is the statement from the IB Physics guide. In IB Physics, you must understand what is meant by acceleration and be able to calculate it. You must remember that it is a vector quantity. Here is a typical multiple choice question on this topic. It shows the motion of an object using a series of dots. You should be able to answer the question by the end of the video. Do you remember that the definition of velocity is the rate of change of displacement with time? The rate of change of the velocity can also be measured. It's called acceleration. Acceleration is a vector, which means that we must state its direction. It is measured in meters per second squared. What does it mean to say that this train has a forward acceleration of 0.4 meters per second squared? Its speed changes by 0.4 meters per second every second. If it starts at a standstill, 1 second later, it will be going at 0.4 meters per second. After another second, at 0.8 meters per second. And after 10 seconds, at 4 meters per second, and so on. Here is the formula. Acceleration, shown as a vector, is the change in the velocity vector divided by the time taken. If the acceleration is changing over time, then this formula gives us its average. Here is an example of a calculation. A trained stunt diver experiences a rapid change in velocity from 24 meters per second down to zero when she enters the water in 0.15 seconds. We can use these data to calculate her acceleration. She's slowing down, and we should be able to recognize the fact in the calculation. First, we write down the information as numbers. Initial velocity is 24, final velocity is 0, and delta t is 0.15 seconds. We can substitute these values into the formula and find her acceleration, noting that the change in velocity is negative. The answer is minus 160 meters per second squared. The negative sign indicates that the acceleration acts in the opposite direction to the velocity. It's upwards. She has slowed down or decelerated. Here is another example. A car is travelling north at 20 meters per second and turns a corner in 2 seconds to travel at 15 meters per second due east. What is its acceleration? The change in velocity here is calculated with vectors, the final velocity minus the initial velocity. It is shown in the vector diagram as v minus u. The black arrow is the change in velocity in magnitude and direction. We can use trigonometry to calculate the change in velocity, which we find is 25 meters per second at 127 degrees from north, and then substitute it into the acceleration formula. The acceleration is given to two significant figures as 13 meters per second at 130 degrees. For this question, the dots are made at equal time intervals. And so if we look at the respective speeds, first of all, it's 10 over t, and then it's 20 over t, and then it's 30 over t. The t is always the same. And therefore, the speed is incrementing equal amounts each time, just because the distances are incrementing by 10 each time. That means that the acceleration is constant since the velocity is changing with the same amount every time interval. Here is the puzzle we set at the start of the video. Can acceleration and velocity be in different directions at the same time? The answer to this question is yes, and in fact we just saw two examples. The car was driving north and then went east, but its acceleration was at an angle to the road. Also in the example with the diver, she was travelling downwards, but her acceleration was in the opposite direction, upwards.